Okay, well, good morning. That took a moment, sorry. Okay, everybody's in now, just making sure everybody's still in. All right, well, I'm gonna turn my phone off now because I wanna make sure I was not totally late. Next week, I won't do that. I won't enable to have to be managed to come in. And then after all my setup, just make sure I can see myself, all lyrical, beautiful, playing with the screen too much. All right, let's breathe. So taking a comfortable seat, whether you're sitting on the floor, sitting on a blanket, and just close your eyes and rest your hands on your thighs. And start to allow your breath to just flow. Not trying to manage it one way or the other, but just allowing it to be. Today, we're going to work through our chakras. There are 7 chakras. I've been doing this for ODU, so I thought I'd do it for us. Setting our chakras in alignment, they go up through the spine. They're the rainbow colors. They go red, orange, yellow, green, indigo, well, turquoise, indigo, and violet. And when they say your chakras are balanced, that you are healthier, mentally and physically. So we're gonna try and balance our chakras today.
Christina,
Sukhasana.
Can you let somebody in the waiting room in?
Oh, okay, another person? Who else needs to be let in? I don't see anybody else. We'll see if
my bad. I think I got Christina's message just now.
Oh, no.
Sorry.
You're okay. We're all here. We're all here.
The gang's all here.
We're gonna align our chakras. All right. So sitting in Sukhasana, or however you are, we're rooting down, which is Muladhara, which is our root chakra. So sitting and feeling anchored to the ground, we'll take our hands heart center. Now let's take a nice inhale and an exhale. And let's open our practice with a round of om. Finding your breath still. Releasing your hands down. Let's take 3 cleansing breaths just to clear the air and settle our hips even more. So taking a nice inhale, sigh it out. Again, inhale, sigh it out. One more time. Returning your breath back to just through your nose. Taking one more deep breath. Slowly open up your eyes and let's transition onto our hands and our knees. Coming onto our tabletop position, stacking your hands underneath your shoulders, your knees underneath your hips. And taking a moment to really feel your hands on the earth, your feet and knees resting. And we'll slowly start to move through our cat-cow. Just rounding and moving on your timing. On the inhale, we lower our belly, lifting our heart, shoulders back. On our exhale, we round and press the earth away. Taking a few more rounds. Again, inhaling on the cow tilts, exhale on the cat pose. Inhale your spine back to neutral. Tuck your toes and then shifting your hips back and up into downward facing dog. Take a few moments to tread through your feet. Maybe swing your hips side to side to help open up the waist and the shoulders. Maybe letting the elbows bend to let the shoulders roll down the back as you shift those hips back and up. Taking another deep breath. And exhale. Inhale, shift forward into your plank position. Exhale, lower the knees down or keep them lifted, your choice in your plank position. Again, inhale and exhale down all the way to the earth, releasing the top of the feet. Lifting your head and chest up for cobra. And exhale down. Again, inhale, working the back muscles to warm them up. Exhale, lower. One more time, inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale, press back up into your push-up position. Tuck your toes again and shifting the hips back and up. And again, it's still early in our practice, you know, a little treading through those feet, a little swaying to those hips, shoulders spreading wide. Allow those heels to try and start to drip down towards the earth. One more deep breath. Inhaling and shift forward into your plank. And again, either in a modified plank or a solid plank, lengthening through the spine. Take one more deep breath. And then exhale, lower to the ground again. Releasing the top of the feet. Inhale, lifting up for cobra. This time, stay up as you exhale. Inhale, lifting, try and have space in the neck. And exhale. One more deep breath. Exhale, release your forehead down. Tucking your toes again, either into a push-up position or a modified plank. Inhale. Exhale, hips to hips. Shift the hips back and up. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Taking two more breaths. One more inhale. And exhale, lower your knees down to the earth. Maybe bring your big toes towards each other, your knees a little bit wider than your hips. And then shifting your hips back and down into child's pose. Making your way onto your heels with your bottom, letting your shoulders relax down, maybe even releasing the elbows. But trying to allow your spine to release back here. Remember, at any point of our practice, you always can come back to child's pose, resting that third eye center or sinking those hips back and down. One more deep breath. On the exhale, press into your hands. And then inhale, lifting your knees up, tuck your toes and shifting your hips back and up. Downward facing dog. Taking one more inhale. And on the exhale, lift your head up and walk or step to the top of your mat. Slide your hands up your shins, reaching your head and heart out. Exhale, release your forehead down. Again, inhale, slide the hands up. Exhale, release. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, reverse your arms, lifting all the way up. Standing up nice and tall. Exhale, hands, heart center. Samasthitihi. Take a moment to breathe, standing tall. Going through a flow. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, folding forward, leading with your chest. Inhale, slide your hands up for Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, place your hands again. Step back into your push-up position. Inhale. Exhale, lower. Cobra, inhale, lifting up. Exhale, down. Tuck your toes, Balakasana, inhale. Exhale, hips back and up, downward facing dog. So as we're here, check those hands, spread them wide. Roll the shoulders out and down, lifting those hips back and up. and the shoulders wide, connecting with your abdominals. One more inhale. And on the exhale, lift your head up, walk a step to the top of your mat. Slide your hands up. Exhale, release. Inhale, sweep those arms all the way up to the sky. Exhale, hands, heart center. One more time. Inhale, swooping up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sliding the hands, really growing the head away. Exhale, place. Stepping back into your push-up position. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, feeling that lift of the upper back. Hands pulling back. Exhale, lower. Inhale, push-up position. Exhale, downward facing dog. Two more breaths. One more inhale. And on the exhale, lift your head up, walk or step to the top of your mat. Slide your hands up your shins, really reach that head and heart away. Exhale, release. Inhale, swooping the arms up all the way. Exhale, hands, heart center, samasthiti ki. Coming to the top of your mat, finding your tadasana. Tadasana is also helping us root down into the earth for our root chakra, muladhara. Feeling those feet anchored to the ground to feel that support of the earth. Taking one more deep breath. Taking your hands to your hips, shift your weight over to your left leg, shifting and lifting that right thigh up in front of us, standing nice and strong, really reaching down into that standing leg, almost like you're stepping up. Remember, you're at home, you're welcome to go to a wall if you need to, or if mom maybe bring a chair over, you can use the chair to help support you. Opening the thigh up to the side, really feeling that engaging of that left leg. And then taking the foot wherever you can place it, either on the inner thigh, placing it onto the calf, or the ball of the foot. Wherever you are, you want to feel the press of both legs in towards each other. And then maybe moving the hands to heart center. Feeling that lift of the chest, feeling the grounding of that standing foot. Feeling that foot pressing in wherever it is, and that hip opening up to stand tall. One more deep breath. And exhale. Inhale, float that leg up in front of you. And then exhale, place it down. Maybe release the hands. Find both feet anchored to the earth. Shoulders down the back. Bring the hands heart center or to our hips. Standing tall, shift the weight over to your right leg, lifting that left thigh up nice and high in front of you. Really want to feel like you're lifting up to press down into the earth. Still working on our root chakra. Take another inhale. Exhale, open the thigh up. Again, either placing it onto the inner thigh, placing it onto the calf, or placing it on the ball of the foot. Never onto the knee. Wherever we find that placement, you want to feel both sides activate and maybe bring the hands heart center. That leg that is pressing into the foot, you want to feel that knee opening up to the sides, lift up through the opposite side's hip. One more deep breath. Inhale, lifting that thigh up in front of you one more time. Exhale, placing the foot down. Finding both feet pressing down into the earth. Inhale, swooping up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, slide your hands up your shins. Exhale, place your hands down and step back into your push-up position. Inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lifting up. Exhale, down. Tuck your toes. Inhale, push-up position. Exhale, back and up. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Shoulders wide, lifting the hips. Take one more deep breath. On the exhale, step your feet together. We're going to inhale, brush your right leg up and behind you. Then exhale, pull that right knee all the way in, placing it between your hands. You're going to turn the left foot down to be parallel with the back side of your mat, lining up that right heel with that left arch. Pressing down, lift the torso up, windmill that left arm back, right arm reaches forward for Virabhadrasana 2. We're now entering the sacral chakra. Svadhisthana, chest is open, lifting up to the chest. This is our hips area. Warrior 2 is great for this pose or this chakra. Inhale, straighten the front leg, lift the arms up. Exhale down, one flow. Its element is water, so we want to keep it moving through those hips. And exhale. Again, stretch. And down, two more. Again, up. And then one more time, lifting up. And exhale. Feel those hips starting to warm up. Turn your right palm over as we lift back, gently placing that hand behind you. Chest is lifting. Still feeling that nice crease in that right hip. Creativity comes from our hips and our sacral chakra. Sexuality comes from the chakra. So we want to keep this flowing. One more inhale. And exhale. Inhale, bring it back. Exhale, straighten the knee. Hands to your hips. We're going to bring our toes towards the side. So both toes are facing the same direction. I don't know what room the side facing today. And then we're going to work the heels in a little bit and then work the toes. We're going in for goddess next. So your legs want to be about a little bit wider than your hips and your toes want to be pointed out just a little bit for you. So we're going to bend into those knees, sinking the hips. Trying to not stick our bottom out, but really lifting up. The hands can come heart center if you'd like. They can stay on your knees, allowing to have a little bit of support. Or you can reach your arms out and lift the earth up as you feel the hips sinking down towards the earth. For our hips, Svadhisthana, sacral chakra. This is help building strength as well as opening up those hips and warming them up. One more inhale and exhale. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, hands to the hips. Turn your toes parallel. Step your left foot to your right foot. Turn to the top of your mat. And inhale, swoop the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, slide your hands up your shins. Exhale, place your hands, step back into your push-up position. Inhale, exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, down. Inhale, back up into plank position. Exhale, hips back and up. Downward facing dog. Two more breaths. Again, really lifting through the abdominals. I like to sink there, I can see. One more inhale and exhale. Stepping your feet close together. Again, inhale, brush the left leg up. This time, bend that left knee in between your hands. You're going to turn your right foot down to be parallel with the back side of that, lining that left heel up with that right arch. Pressing down, we're going to windmill our right arm to the back. Left arm reaches forward for warrior 2. I'm going to flip myself around. Virabhadrasana 2, still working on our sacral chakra, finding our focus, find those nice hips opening. Inhale, straighten that front leg. Exhale, bend. Again, inhale. Exhale. Three more times. Inhale, reach. Little dynamic movement flowing, helping our water flow. Inhale. Exhale. Again. And exhale. Reverse warrior, reach of Virabhadrasana. Turn the left palm over, reach into the back of the room. Being careful about how you gently place that back arm, your right arm to your right leg, keeping that left knee bent, lifting up through the chest. Be mindful of what's happening in that left knee. Make sure it hasn't fallen inward. It's really still opening up to the side. Shoulders trying to release as best they can. Take another inhale and exhale. Inhale back up to warrior two. Inhale, straighten that front leg. Hands to our hips. Turn your left toes inward. Working those feet inward again. And then we'll turn those heels in just a little bit. So the legs are not too wide. Again, setting up for goddess pose. So taking a nice lift of the chest. And exhale, sinking it down. Again, trying to keep your bottom underneath you. Again, the knees pressing outward. Taking the arms maybe out to the side and lifting up, or hands heart center. Take a nice inhale and exhale. Maybe lift a little inhale and exhale, sink. Again, inhale, exhale, lower. Again, up and down. One more of these lovely pulses, up and low. Beautiful, ladies and gentlemen, up. Exhale, hands to your hips. Turn your toes parallel. Stepping your right to your left. Turn to the top of your mat. Swoop the arms up to the sky. Exhale, folding forward. Hands the arms all the way up to the sky. Hands heart center. Again, inhale, lifting up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, slide in the hands. Exhale, place your hands down. You're going to step back with your left foot. Placing it on the ball of the left foot, keeping that right knee bent. Pressing down into the earth as you lift your torso up, hands to your hips. Maybe working that right foot out just a little bit for a high crescent lunge. We're lifting the heart up. We're now shifting to our solar plexus, our Manipura, lustrous gem. Kind of getting our twisting involved here. Inhale, swooping the arms up. Maybe exhale, let the arms come down the back. Again, inhale, up. Exhale, maybe elbows bend, let the arms come back. One more time, up. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale, hands heart center. There's a couple of variations. I'm going to do the hardest variation first. Take a nice inhale. You're going to exhale, lean forward. And then twist to your right. You're going to try and hook the left elbow over that right knee. If that is not available, take the left hand down to the earth and reach the arms wide. The right hand can also place onto that right thigh. And we can always do it onto our knee as well. So either in the high crescent lunge with the elbow hooked, hand on the earth, we're trying to twist that solar plexus, the belly button, to the breastbone. Taking a nice inhale and exhale. Again. And exhale. One more deep breath. And exhale. Inhale, unwind. Exhale, hands down to the earth. Lower the left knee down, if it's not already down there. And we're going to shift back, straightening out that front leg. I'm just giving a gentle stretch here to that right leg. Allowing those hips to try and stay even. Remember, you can use your hands, fingertips. If you don't have blocks, blocks are very helpful here. Whatever you have, and even a chair or stool. Taking one more deep breath and exhale. Inhale, shift forward back into your lunge. Tucking the left toes under, lifting that knee up. Stepping the left foot back to the top of the mat. Slide the hands up the shins. Exhale, release. Inhale, stand all the way up to the side. Exhale, hands turn center to the flip sides here. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, slide your hands. Exhale, place your hands. Step back with your right foot this time. Feeling that right hip opening up strong to that left foot. Inhale, lifting the hands up to the hips. Again, two hips are trying to face forward. We're lifting up the chest, strong through that back leg. We're connecting through here. Lifting the arms up, inhale. Maybe exhale, bend the elbows and let the arms come behind you, trying to open up that upper body. Inhale, exhale back. Two more times. Inhale, strong back leg. Exhale, you can always do high crescent on your knee, so it's low crescent. One more time. And exhale. Inhale, lifting up. Exhale, hands toward center. So remember, we have a couple variations. Take a nice inhale. Exhale, lean forward, twisting. This time, your right elbow is going to move over that left knee, twisting through the chest. Maybe placing your right hand down, left arm up, or left hand down with the knee down. Whatever variation works best for your body, challenging what you need to challenge. Wherever you're twisting is stimulating that solar plexus, that Manipura chakra, helping realign it. Two more deep breaths. One more inhale and exhale. Inhale, unwind. Exhale, lower your hands down to the earth. Lowering that right knee if it's not already lowered. Shifting it back into half splits, half paramasana. Trying to make your hips still facing forward, your toes pulling back towards you. Again, if you have blocks or something to help lift up. Even if you're up here, just trying to get a nice counter stretch from that challenging pose. Give me a nice hamstring stretch. Taking one more inhale. And exhale. Inhale, shift forward into your lunge. Tucking your right toes under. Lifting that knee, hop it all the way forward. Slide your hands up your shins. Exhale, place your hands down and step back into your push-up position. Inhale, exhale, lower. Inhale, lifting up. Exhale, down. Tuck your toes, inhale, back up into your push-up position. Exhale, hips back and up. Downward facing dog. Taking two more breaths. One more inhale and exhale. Inhale, shift forward into your plank. Exhale, lower all the way down to the earth. Going into one more cobra. Inhale, lifting up. Exhale, staying for a breath. One more inhale. Exhale, release your head down. Let your arms go down by your sides. Shifting the hips side to side. We're shifting now into Anahata, which is our heart chakra, which is for compassion and love. This is where the back bending, we're opening up that heart, is going to come into play. So, taking your arms down by your side, bringing your nose forward, shoulders roll down the back, palms are facing the earth. Inhale, lifting your chest and your legs, everything is up. Again, really trying to pull that chest forward and up to open up your heart chakra. Inhale, and exhale. Not being holding your neck too much. One more deep breath. Exhale, release your head down, turning your head sideways the other direction. Letting your shoulders release. Rocking those hips side to side. With our heart chakra, sometimes it starts to open us up for a little vulnerability while we're working through all the chakras. Hopefully the heart can be opened for forgiveness. Taking one more inhale and exhale. Inhale your forehead center. You can stick with this variation of Shalabhasana, or you can interlace your fingers behind your back, and we'll do locust pose C or Shalabhasana C. So reaching the hands away, lifting everything up again. Inhale and exhale. So not making it about the shoulders, but making it about reaching the heart forward. Inhale and exhale, lifting through the body. Two more breaths. Do your breathing still. One more inhale. Exhale, release everything down, turning your head sideways, shaking those hips side to side. Maybe finding some stillness or even giving yourself a slight lower back massage or a neck massage. And one more back bend that really opens up that heart, I think, would be bow pose or dhanurasana. So we're going to inhale your forehead center. You can stick with either variation, they both open your heart just as nicely. Or you can bend your heels towards your bottom, and you're going to reach for your ankles. Flexing the foot so the toes are over that wrist. And again, pulling back with the shoulders, lifting the heart. Again, this really helps open up that chest. And then we kick into those heels to really expose that heart. Inhale and exhale. Letting it lead the way. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath. And exhale. Release the legs. Release your head. Turning it the other way one last time. Finding stillness. Or a gentle rock. Inhale your forehead center, taking your hands by your shoulders. You're going to come up to a tabletop position, and you're going to walk your knees forward. We're going to do one more back bend. This is for our throat chakra, so we're shifting up to our throat chakra, Yoshida, which we're going to use camel for. So if you happen to have a block or a pillow or something, you can sit on it between your legs to kind of help prop you up. Generally don't like this because this kills this right knee for me, but this is a nice way. Or if you're capable of it, you can also just sit on your heels. So for camel, just going to show it really quick how we want to get into it. When you come up onto your knees, you can take your hands. There are a couple of options. Either taking your fingertips up to the sky, your fingertips down, or you can make fists. But it's about opening up through here for our throat chakra. So we're gonna do two rounds of camel. First one, we're not gonna go all the way down. So sometimes it's helpful to have the toes tucked under or not. Placing your hands at the small of your back, lifting up to the front of your pelvis, standing nice and tall, feeling those shoulders open. We take a nice inhale, lift the chest up. So we're all joining me here, and we allow that neck to open. So we're opening up that throat chakra. Inhale, and only go as far as you can. Inhale, and exhale. One more deep breath, and exhale. Inhale, lead with the head first, and support yourself up. And then sitting down on your heels, you sit down on your block or a pillow here, and just take a moment. Maybe you take your hand over your heart, in your solar plexus, letting yourself calm down for a moment as we're stimulating the energies in the body with the chakras, or going through the chakras, the energies. We're going to do that one more time. You can do it the exact same way, or you can take your hands down to your heels in the back bend portion. Just be mindful that you want to be careful what you do here. And sometimes if you're going to take your hands back, that's where those tucking the toes is a good option. So again, lifting up on top of your knees, supporting your abdominals, really trying to stack your hips on top of your knees. Take a nice inhale, lifting up. And then if available, so you can take your hands down to your feet, really pressing up, letting that head open up that neck. Hands can stay at the lower back. Two more breaths. Moving your hands to your lower back first, then lifting the head up. And then exhale, sitting your hips again, back and down onto your block. Quieten your mind, maybe placing a hand on the solar plexus and the heart. Breathing. They also say sound helps stimulate the throat chakra. So you can keep your hands here. We can just do a nice round of om. So just taking a cleansing breath first. Take a nice inhale. Exhale it out. Inhale for om. Throat chakra says we speak the truth, purification. So we're making ourselves more pure as we open that throat chakra. If you have the block under your hips, you're going to shift that block out of the way. You're going to make your way into child's pose, allowing your hips to sink back and down, your arms reaching out. And really connecting that third eye, as we're shifting to our third eye chakra, ajna. Letting our forehead either rest on the floor or connecting it to a block. Wherever it goes, allow your arms to maybe rest. And just allow that connection of that third eye to maybe release. You might even want to just gently roll the head side to side to help stimulate that third eye, giving it a gentle massage. The hands can go down by your side if that feels better for you. And just allow that third eye, which allows us to have intuition, imagination, our sight. Two more deep breaths here. One more inhale and exhale. Inhale, pressing into your hands, coming back into a tabletop position. And we'll make our way into staff pose, Dandasana. We're still working on our third eye chakra. I'm going to do a nice forward fold here. So either with your hands by your hips, or on your thighs, take a nice inhale. And then exhale, slowly walk your hands forward again, allowing that head to round forward. Allowing that head to come down. Finding ease in the back of the body. Letting the body flow and feel stretched. As we're aligning our chakras, hopefully it's helping our body feel more balanced. Maybe being able to let go of all the craziness around the world right now. And just like life, we still are having our craziness going on in our life as well. Because life still does go on, whether we're stuck in our house or not. Taking one more inhale and exhale. Inhale, slowly walking the hands back in, lifting up the heart, and the shoulders down the back. We're going to bend our knees. Letting your knees open up for our bound angle pose, Baddha Konasana, as we're starting to shift into Sahasrara, the crown, or final chakra, chakra 7, which is the violet chakra, white, or is in basically enlightenment. Everything is now allowing our brain to be open for thought and possibilities. Exhale, rounding over. Also in our bound angle pose, it helps us let go of our lower back and our hips, finding ease in the whole back side of the body. Inhale, lifting your heart up. Exhale, relax. Bringing your hands under your thighs, bringing your knees together, and again, giving yourself a little hug. And that crown of the head round forward. Our next pose, you're going to extend your legs long. This is fish pose or Matsyendrasana pose, which allows us to reach the top of our head. It's another back bend of sorts. You're going to lean back onto your elbows. You're going to let your head go back. We're trying to work our elbows forward to get the top of our head onto the earth. And it really helps us open up the front body. If this is not possible, you can also just prop your elbows and let your head just hang. But if possible, you slide those elbows forward to the top of the head, connect with the earth, really pressing down with the elbows, flexing through the feet to really lift and engage those legs. Two more breaths here. One more inhale and exhale. To get out of it, lift your head up and slowly roll down through your spine. And then extend the arms over the head, reaching the legs far away from you. Find that nice reach. And then bring the knees back into the chest one at a time. Maybe taking a gentle rock side to side, or maybe even circling the knees around. And lifting your forehead to your knees to get that nice counter stretch there. Letting your head release down. Placing your feet down onto the earth. We're going to cross the right thigh over the left by flexing into that right foot, sitting up for our number 4. You're going to bring in those legs to your chest. You're going to take your hands, thread them through your right and left thigh, grabbing a hold of that left thigh. For Sutrasana, thread the needle pose. Your right elbow can press into that right thigh, giving a nice hip opener. Allowing that back to feel supported on the ground. as we've gone through all of our chakras. Still working on that last sahasrara. Having the head feeling connected to the earth. Allowing that energy to flow from your coccyx bone all the way through the top of the head. Releasing the hands down. Taking your arms out into a T or into a goalpost arms. And you can allow your knee to fall over to the left, creating a nice twist. Now that right knee can stay directly up. You can reach the right arm long, and that gives a nice stretch from the arm all the way down to the hip. Or a different stretch, you can let the knee fall inward. Whatever works best for your body and your needs to help unwind the back from the back bending we've done. Maybe looking away from the legs. Taking one more deep breath. Exhale it out. Inhale, bringing that knee back up. Giving it a gentle stretch up to the sky, wiggling it out. Pull that knee into your chest. One more final stretch. Extend that left leg long. Just feel that nice crease of that right knee into your chest, pressing that left thigh down. And then bring that left knee back in the joint. Again, just giving a gentle rock. Maybe lifting the forehead up. Placing your head down. And then you're going to place your right foot down this time, crossing the left foot over, breathing a number four, flexing that left foot. You're going to bring the right thigh into your chest, threading your left hand through the left and right thigh, basically grabbing a hold of your right thigh this time. The left elbow compressed gently onto that left knee as we find that nice hip opener, maybe a little lower back stretch there. Allowing that head to feel supported and resting on the earth. Lining up all the chakras, letting them flow energy-wise, trying to unblock any blockages of energy to rebalance us. One more deep breath. Releasing the hands, letting the foot go down to the earth. And again, opening your arms into a T or goalpost. This time allowing your legs to fall to the right. And either keeping that left knee up, reaching the elbow long, feeling that stretch all the way through the hip and shoulder, or letting the knee drop forward inward and allowing the head to either look towards the legs or away from the legs. Whatever stretch I feel best from all our back bending we did today. It's nice to unwind the back and help re-neutralize it as well. Twisting also helps stimulate our digestive system to get that part of the body working better. On your inhale, maybe fill up your lungs. On the exhale, your twist gets just a tiny bit deeper. One more deep breath. Inhale, bringing those knees back up to center. Releasing that left leg, giving it a gentle wag in the air. And then bending that left knee into your chest and extending that right leg long, flexing into that right foot. And feeling that nice crease into the stomach, to the chest, but also helping us open up that right thigh. And then bringing that right knee into your chest. And again, gently rocking there side to side, lifting your head up to those legs, releasing the head down. You like and open your knees up, lift your heels to the sky, reaching for your feet for one more final happy baby, final stretch. Maybe finding a gentle rock, extending the leg, letting those hips release. Sometimes I like to let the knees relax and just go into the hips a little bit here. And then you find what you've got enough stretch. And you give yourself one more rounding up before you send yourself long into your shavasana. Whether that be with your knees bent, putting your knees towards each other, working your feet out towards the edge of the mat so the knees can gently rest on each other. Or if it's with your legs extended long into full shavasana, allowing the hands to hang down by your side. Wherever you relax into your shavasana, allow your head to feel supported in the earth. The shoulders up and down the back. Maybe give a gentle heel rock to allow whatever tension might be still left in that body to let go. The shoulders sliding down. And as you lay here, try and let go of each part. Letting the head and that top chakra release. The throat chakra, the neck and shoulders to let go. The heart chakra can soften. The solar plexus, the middle of the body, letting support and release. Down to our hips and our sacrum. Down to our coccyx and our sitting area. Our root chakra. As it goes all the way down into your feet. Letting everything let go and feeling the ground support you as your body rests. Slowly reconnecting back with your breath. Letting your chest rise and fall. Slowly bringing breath back into your fingers and your toes. As they slowly start to move, waking up. As maybe it shifts into your wrists and your ankles. Elbows and your knees. So gradually you can reach those arms up and over your head, reach those heels far away, giving yourself one more final length stretch. And then bringing the knees into your chest. Maybe giving a gentle squeeze, maybe even lifting that head up. And when you're ready, rolling onto your side, bringing both shoulders and hips with you, using that bottom arm as a pillow. Reconnecting the mind and the body. Gently pressing into your top arm, bring yourself back up to a seated position to restack our spine and our chakras. You remember what leg you crossed in front first, maybe switching those legs, resting the hands on the thighs. And just close the eyes. And just maybe kind of try and take a moment to visualize each chakra. The base one is red, our hips is orange, our solar plexus is yellow, our heart is green, our throat is turquoise, our third eye is indigo and violet is our final chakra. And they go in that nice rainbow order. Hopefully we've balanced them out a little bit today. Let's bring our hands heart center. Let's close with three cleansing breaths and one round of Om. So just taking one breath to get all on the same page. Inhale and exhale. Now we cleanse. Inhale, sigh it out. Again, inhale. One more time. Inhale for Om. Thank you so much for allowing me to lead you through this practice. Hopefully your chakras and your mind are a little bit more balanced. Namaste. Thank you so much, everybody. I hope you all are having